Are you looking for an easy, no dig, no concrete option for replacing your mailbox and post? If so, this video is for you. Whether your mailbox got knocked over, or you just want a new one, or in my case, the mailman jamming boxes that don't really fit and causing the post to break and you need to get up a new one real fast, whatever the case, I'm going to show you how to install a mailbox post DIY with no digging involved. And I'm doing this for the first time, so you can learn along with me. I'll show you how I completed the whole project, and by the end of the video, I'll tell you what I think about it and if I would do it again. Like most things, preparation is the key before getting started. When looking at my options, I came to an in-ground anchor post kit made by Gibralter Mailboxes, which involves a steel stake that goes into the ground, and then a 4x4 wood post that goes onto the stake. I'll show you all this in a minute, so don't click away. Now, Gibralter is a popular name in mailboxes, and according to their website, they've been around since 1957. Now, as a heads up, no one is sponsoring this video, so I'm not recommending anything. I'm just telling you the products I used and where I got them. Now, for this kit, I was able to get it from the Home Depot for $15.90. Well, I actually got it twice because the first one I bought had lumber that was cracked and I didn't want to risk breaking it when I had to drive it onto the stake. So I returned that one and got another one. Now, the second one was fine, so I don't know if this is a typical issue or just a rare one, but either case, I had a kit that was ready to go. So as you can see here, the wood is pre-drilled to make it fairly easy to get the wood onto the stake. And how it works is that you drive the thick part of the stake into the ground, leaving the narrower part above the ground, and then this is the part that the wood post goes over so it can stand up and support the mailbox. Now, one thing that concerned me about the wood is that it wasn't treated. While the wood won't be in the ground with this setup, it will be sitting on it, so the bottom of the post could get damp and start to rot and possibly get bugs in it or whatever, so I decided to just paint the bottom of the post really quickly with some spray paint, just to give it a little extra barrier there. Not in the instructions, just something extra I wanted to do to maybe just add a little extra life to it. So to get started with anchoring the post, I measured how far off the road I wanted the post to be so that the opening of the mailbox would be at the proper distance in regards to the road, so that it was close enough for the mailman to put the mail in it, but not hanging over the road where it could get hit. Once I got that figured out, I used a decent sized hammer to pound the steel stake in. As you can see, I didn't use a big sledgehammer because I wanted to go slow and make sure I was pounding it in straight. To double check that, I used a level a couple of times before I got the stake all the way driven in. After the stake was in, I put the wood post on top of the stake to start driving it on. Interestingly, the instructions on the website said to do this in this order, while the instructions on the box said to put the stake in the post before driving it into the ground. Now, I was concerned with that, even though the wood post was drilled out, that too much hammering could split the wood. And also because of that concern, I decided to use a mallet instead of a hammer to prevent a potential split. After I got it started, I also was able to use my own weight to push it down some without the impact of pounding on the wood. I double checked again with the level to make sure it was straight, and other than a couple little side taps, I was good there. Driving the wood the last couple of inches was getting harder, so I used the hammer fairly gently to finish it off. So I accomplished my goal of not splitting the post. Now at the end of the video, I'll tell you what I think about the install and how sturdy it is. But before I get to that, and now that I got the post in, the next thing to finish up this project was to put the mailbox post sleeve over the wood. Now you can use any 4x4 mailbox sleeve you want, as long as it fastens within about 23 inches from the bottom, because that's the length of the post. The mailbox post sleeve and mailbox I used was one from Postal Pro named the Madison Mailbox and Post Kit. I also got this from Home Depot, and it cost $47.48. I like the look of it from the picture on the box and the website, but I have to admit it looked a little bit more plasticky in person. Anyway, it just slips over the wood post, and then you have to put in four screws that go through the sleeve and into the wood post. Before I bought the mailbox kit, I did make sure that all the screws would go in within 23 inches from the ground, so I knew I wouldn't have any issues there. The next step is attaching the mounting bracket to the mailbox post. The mounting bracket is what the actual mailbox connects to. For this particular kit, there's four screws you screw in from the top, as you can see me doing. And then the last step is attaching the mailbox to the mounting bracket. For this setup, again, there are four screws you drive in from the side. So you have just a total of 12 screws that you have to install for the whole project. There you go, all installed. So what do I think? Well, overall, this was a pretty easy project to complete and probably only took 15 to 20 minutes total to complete once I had all the tools and both the anchoring and mailbox kits ready to go. Attaching the mailbox post sleeve and mailbox was super easy, so there's not too much to say there. Probably the thing you're wondering most about was using the no-dig Gibralter anchor post kit. I have to say, it really wasn't that hard to drive the stake into the ground, and I think as long as you don't have super hard or rocky ground to work with, most people could get it in there. You don't have to be a muscle-bound guy to do this. I mean, just look at me. Anyways, so I think it's a real easy and quick DIY project to complete. Now, I will say I'm not sure how it will hold up over time. It doesn't feel super sturdy when you pull and push on the post. Now, having said that, when I put some decent pressure on it, while it flexes, it does come back to the original position every time. I'm sure Gibralter engineered this to be as cost-effective as possible while still doing the job, but there's a couple of things I think they could have done to make it feel more solid or sturdy. One would be to use a longer wood post for a little bit more support for the post sleeve, and also because some sleeves might require a higher attachment point for the screws to go in at. I also think using treated lumber would make sense since the wood post will be sitting right on top of the ground. The other thing I think could be done, or maybe someone could do on their own, is to attach some smaller metal stakes around the main stake to give it some more support. Again, I'm sure the company studied this a lot and found that what they sell works, so these are just my own thoughts. But overall, I would say I'm happy with how easy it was to install, it's doing the job, and I would consider doing it again, depending on how it holds up. I'll keep you posted. Anyways, I hope you found the video helpful, and if you did, please like it. And if you enjoy doing a variety of DIY projects, definitely consider subscribing, as I'm looking to do a lot of different types of videos on this channel. And if you're interested in DIY investing and financial types of videos, check out my first channel, Healthy, Wealthy, and Wise. I'll link it for you in the description. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day. Take care.